Hello everyone, in the last video of clauses, we talk about one special class of subordinate clauses, which is adjective clause, and its two subtypes, restrictive clauses and non-restrictive clauses. Remember, this concept is very important for you to understand modifiers, because non-restrictive clauses generally don't have a problem in modifier errors, but restrictive clauses do. A lot of students ask me whether they can use commas and convert a restrictive clause into a non-restrictive clause to solve a modifier error. No, you can't do that. If it's a restrictive clause, it has to remain in that form, particularly for the reason that it is essential information and you cannot make it a optional information while making the correction. So it is imperative for you to understand the difference between these two very clearly in this class. Okay, so adjective clause is a subordinate clause which acts as a adjective in the sentence. Like an adjective, it modifies the noun or the pronoun in the sentence. Now we have two types. First is the restrictive clause. It is essential to the meaning of a sentence because it limits the thing it is referring to. For example, it is saying the gas company will discontinue our service unless we pay our bills by Friday. So it is restricting as to what action you can do by adding a restrictive clause saying that it will discontinue only if you don't pay your bill by Friday. So it is restricting the discontinue part, right? The second thing it says, the meaning of the sentence would change if the clause were deleted. So let's read it without the clause. The company will discontinue our service. So it is saying that no matter what, it will discontinue our service. So if I remove this restrictive clause, then it will change the meaning. Okay. Third is, they are not set off by commas. So you don't see any commas in the sentence. So remember, this is how you identify restrictive clauses. Let's look at the second example. The car that I want is out of my price range. Out of my price range is the restrictive clause. Now it's not set off by commas. If I were to see that it is also restricting, the car that I want is out of my price range, so it's setting a limit of price to the main sentence. And if I was to remove this, the car that I want, then it will not make any sense. So it's a restrictive clause. Vis-a-vis, you have non-restrictive clauses. They are extra non-essential information, which means that even if you remove them, it wouldn't change, right? And it wouldn't damage the core of the sentence. And they are set off by commas. For example, Puerto Rico was a Spanish colony in 1898. If you stop here, it will also make sense. But it is giving you an additional information by putting in a comma when it was ceded to United States. So it's saying it was a Spanish colony up until this point, and after that it was ceded to United States, which is an additional information. So this part is your non-restrictive clause. It is it does not change the meaning of the sentence. It is additional and it is set off by commas. If you want another example, I can give you another example of non-restrictive clauses. Let's say Aniket, who wrote ABC, is an inventor. Now, who wrote ABC is the non-restrictive clause. Even if I was to slash it away, Aniket is an inventor is a perfectly fine sentence. It is just giving an additional information that as an inventor, he wrote this. Secondly, it's all set off by commas. So I hope with this, it is clear the difference between restrictive clauses versus non-restrictive clauses. And that's where we end this session. Thank you so much.